put a second one on this one, it'll bend a little more, but not bad.
We can't even put it on this
one. If I put one on this, it's going to break in half. Yeah. it's just going to snap.
Oh, it's making me cringe.
Hi, this is Jason with Hoverstream. By now you've probably heard about how our new Evolution hovercraft is built in a much different way than other hovercraft or even our own previous models. Supposedly this means it's stronger and lighter. If you're anything like me, hearing a company describe their new product as revolutionary or the latest technology or better than anything before, it'll probably trigger an immediate feeling of skepticism. How many times have we heard big claims only to later learn that the new and improved widget is not so different after all? I've been wanting to make a video showcasing our new hull materials because they really are quite impressive, but that's tricky to show in a video. If I handed over two material samples and asked you to compare them, even a child could easily do so. You could try bending each one, see how much flex there is, feel the weight of each piece, and easily form an opinion of each item that is likely to be quite accurate, at least compared to the one next to it. Obviously, that method is purely subjective, so here's how we did it. First, we made a list of all the various sample materials we wanted to compare, then put them through our resin infusion process. Those pieces were then trimmed down so that they were all equal-sized sample cards. Then we tested the deflection of each sample material with progressively higher weight and recorded the results. This generated a ton of useful data, allowing us to scientifically compare the strength-to-weight ratio of many different samples. At this point, we could throw a bunch of graphs and test numbers at you, but aside from guaranteeing a really boring video, it probably won't help much unless you're an engineer and used to dealing with that kind of data. So instead, we're going to use some less scientific, but hopefully more entertaining visuals.
I'm worried about putting all my weight on this, but...
crunchy.
Here we have three different sample materials. The first is a piece of the traditional standard hand-laid matte fiberglass. This particular sample was cut from a Coastal Pro 2 hull and weighs about 100 grams. Second, at 77 grams, is a piece of the honeycomb material that we're using for many of our Evolution parts, primarily non-structural components. The last sample is very similar to the second, except we've replaced the thin honeycomb with a thicker structural foam core. This makes the panel thickness about 5 times that of the honeycomb. Note that the weight is 100 grams, the same as the first sample. Here we've set those three samples up to make a bridge spanning two sawhorses. We're going to set a 10-pound steel weight in the middle of each bridge so that you can see how much they bend. Then maybe we'll get creative with additional weight from there. You can see the matte fiberglass by itself is quite weak, and 10 pounds is about all it can take. The honeycomb panel, on the other hand, at 23% less weight, just barely bends. And the foam panel, well, you can't even tell I put weight on it. So let's keep adding weight and see what happens.
No bend. If I put a second one on this one, it'll bend a little more, but not bad.
We can't even put it on this one.
If I put one on this, it's going to break in half. Yeah, it's just going to snap.
Oh, that's making me cringe.
I think. Yeah.
My entire body weight on that one.
Do it again?
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, it's barely even moving. Hold on, third time.
It's not even...
balance.
So I've temporarily attached the upper sides here, and it's not attached in the front at all, and it's not got any adhesive anywhere. It's exclusively being held by the clay hose right now. Now, keep in mind that this entire side, really all of these panels, the rivets are not structurally supporting the part. The rivets are really just there to make sure that there's clamping force while the adhesive cures. And the adhesive is actually what is going to provide the real strength. Even so, I want to show how stiff the sidewall is. If you are familiar with the Coastal Pro or the Marlin or any of the previous generation models, you'll know that they were very lightweight sides. They were not intended to be stepped on or have any weight put directly on them. We wanted to make sure this craft was not only lighter than the Coastal Pro, but also had the robust stiffness to support someone stepping on the side, you know, people using them hard, bringing equipment in and out of the machine, rescue units, you know, pulling people out of the water or ice over the side, all these heavy, hard uses. So we climb up there right now.
So here, keeping in mind that these, where this wool have rivets, the rivets are just there to put clamping force on the part while the adhesive cures. The adhesive is actually what gives us the strength. And this is not glued at all right now. It's only just temporarily attached. But that said, I'll stand on this just to show how stiff it is. There is no movement at all. You would think this kind of strength comes with a lot of weight. This entire side is 13 pounds. So very, very lightweight composite panel.